Rules of divisibility. Any number is divisible by 2 when the last digit of the number is divisible by 2, or when the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. All of these are divisible by 2. For example, the number 95,354 is divisible by 2 because the last digit of the number is 4, which is divisible by 2. Therefore, the number divided by 2 results in 47,677. A number is divisible by 4 if the number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4. For example, the number 3456 is divisible by 4 because the last two digits of the number are 5 and 6, and the number formed by them is therefore 56, which is divisible by 4, and the division results in 14. Therefore, the number itself is divisible by 4, and the division results in 864. A number is divisible by 8 if the number formed by its last three digits is divisible by 8. For example, in the given number, the last three digits are 1, 2, and 8. And the number formed by them is 128, which is divisible by 8 because 128 divided by 8 is equal to 16. Therefore, the number itself is divisible by 8 and the division results in 956766. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of all its digits is divisible by 3. For example, in this number, the digits are 1, 7, 0, 6, 8, and 2, and their sum equals 24, which is divisible by 3, because 24 divided by 3 is equal to 8. Therefore, the number itself is divisible by 3 and the division results in 56,894. Any number is divisible by 6 if the number is divisible both by 2 and 3. For example, the number 5,688 is divisible by 6 because the last digit of the number is 8, which is divisible by 2, and the sum of all its digits is equal to 5 plus 6 plus 8 plus 8 is equal to 27, which is divisible by 3 because 27 divided by 3 equals 9. Therefore, the number itself is divisible by 6, where 6 is a multiple of both 2 and 3. Therefore, 5,688 divided by 6 results in 948. A number is divisible by 9 if the sum of all its digits is divisible by 9. For example, in this given number, the digits are 5, 8, 4, 2, 1, 5, 0, and 2. And the sum of the digits are 27, where 27 is divisible by 9, because 27 divided by 9 is equal to 3. Therefore, the number itself is divisible by 9, and the division results in 6, 4, 9, 1, 2, 7, 8. Any number is divisible by 5 if the last digit of the number is 0 or 5. For example, 935 is divisible by 5 because the last digit of the number is 5. Therefore, 935 divided by 5 results in 187. Similarly, 10 is divisible by 5 and the division results in 2 because the last digit of 10 is 0. If the last digit of any number is 0, then the number is to be divisible by 10. For example, 100 is divisible by 10 and the division results in 10 because the last digit of 100 is 0. To determine if a number is divisible by 7, take the last digit of the number, double it, and subtract the doubled number from the remaining number. If the result is evenly divisible by 7, then the number is divisible by 7. For example, 1015 is divisible by 7. If we take the last digit of the number, then the remaining number is 101. And if we double the last digit, we get that 2 times 5. And the subtraction gives us that 101 minus 2 times 5, which results in 101 minus 10 is equal to 91, while 91 is divisible by 7 because 91 divided by 7 is equal to 13. Therefore, 1015 is divisible by 7 and the division results in 145. A number is divisible by 11 if the difference between the sum of the digit in the odd positions and the sum of the digit in the even positions is divisible by 11. For example, in this given number, the sum of the digit in the odd positions is equal to 6 plus 6 plus 8 because the odd positions are first, third and fifth position, in where the digits are 6, 6 and 8 respectively. And so the sum of the digit in the odd position is equal to 6 plus 6 plus 8 is equal to 20. Similarly, the digit 2 and 7 are in the second and fourth position respectively, that is, they are the digit in the even positions, and therefore their sum is 2 times 7 is equal to 9. Therefore, the difference equals 20 minus 9 equals 11, which is divisible by 11. Therefore, the number is divisible by 11 and the division results in 5698. Even an odd integer. If any integer is divisible by 2, it is called an even integer. Otherwise, it is an odd integer. When an odd integer is divided by 2, the remainder is always 1. For example, when we divide 5 by 2, we can get that 5 is equal to 2 times 2 plus 1, where 1 is the remainder, 5 is the dividend, 2 is the quotient, and 2 is the divisor. Here, the set of even integers and the set of odd integers are shown. we can see here that 2, 4, 6 and so on are the elements of the set of even integers, and 1, 3, 5 and so on with other odd integers are the elements of the set of odd integers. Useful facts regarding the sum and product of even and odd integers. The addition of two even integers results in an even integer. For example, 4 plus 6 is equal to 10, where 10, 6 and 4, all three are even integers. The addition of or the sum of two odd integers results in an even integer. For example, 5 plus 7 is equal to 12, where 12 is an even integer, 5 and 7 are odd integers. The sum of an even integer and an odd integer results in an odd integer. For example, 1 plus 4 is equal to 5, where 5 is an odd integer, 4 is an even integer, and 1 is an odd integer. The product of two even integers results in an even integer. For example, 4 times 6 is equal to 24, where 24, 6 and 4, all of 3 are even integers. On the other hand, the product of two odd integers results in an odd integer. For example, 5 times 7 is equal to 35, where 35, 7 and 5, all of them are odd integers. The product of an even integer and an odd integer results in an even integer. For example, 4 times 5 is equal to 20, where 20 is an even integer, 4 is an even integer, but 5 is an odd integer. Thanks for watching. Persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from Higher Study Prep.